Roman numerals follow a symbolic representation for numbers. Some of the Roman numerals are I is used for 1, V is used for 5, X is used for 10, L is used for 50, C is used for 100, D is used for 500, M is used for 1000. There are few rules for writing the Roman numerals. The first rule says that if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it occurs. For an example, 1, we write Roman numeral as I. For 2, which is 1 plus 1, we write I 2 times. For 3, we write I 3 times. Similarly, for 10, we will write 1x. For 20, we will write 2x. And for 30, we will write 3x. The second rule says that the symbols for 1, 10, 100 and 1000 can be repeated up to 3 times only. But the symbols for 5, 50 and 500 cannot be repeated. The third rule says that if the symbol of a smaller value is written to the right of the symbol of a greater value, then the values get added. Now let's understand over here that I, which has a smaller value as 1, is written to the right of V, which is having a greater value. So here we will add 5 plus 1, which give me the value as 6. The fourth rule says that if the symbol of a smaller value is written to the left of the symbol of a greater value, then the value will be subtracted from the greater symbol. That means 5 minus 1 will give me 4. Also, the symbols V, L, D, X, C, M are never written on the left side of the greater symbol. So that means these symbols are never subtracted. Let us take some Roman number examples. 1 is written as I, 2 times I, 3 is written as 3 times I. For 4, we cannot write 4 times I. Why? Because our rule says that we can repeat a number up to 3 times only. We know how to write 5. 5 can be represented as V. So what are we going to do? We are going to place 1 to the left of V, which is 5 minus 1 gives us 4. Similarly, for writing 6, we will write plus 1, VI. Writing towards right will add the given number. For 7, we will write V11. For 8, we will write VIII. That means 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. For 9, we will write 10 minus 1. And for 10, we will write X. Some other examples are, for 10, we write X. For 20, we write 2 times X. For 30, we write down 3 times X. For 40, we write 50 minus 10, that is XL. And for 50, we write L. Similarly, for others, we will write like this. So, 13 is written as 10 plus 3. For 10, we use X as a Roman numeral. And for 3, we will use 3 times I. So, the Roman numeral becomes XIII. For 14, we will write 10 plus 5 minus 1, that is XIV. For 27, we can write 20 plus 7, and 20 is written as X and X, 10 plus 10. For 7, I can break down into 5 plus 2. 5 means V, and 2 means 2 times I. Now, taking 19, 19 is nothing but 10 plus 9. Now, 10 represent X and 9 represents 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 is nothing but IX. For 54, we can write down 50 plus 4. L represents 50 and 4 is IV. For 84, we can write 50 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. 50, 60, 70, 80. And for 4, we can write IV. Similarly, for 94, we can write 100 minus 10 as 90, which is XC, and 4 means IV. So it is written as XCIV. Hope you understand, children. Children, now let's take example of bigger number and let us write down them in Roman numerals. You're already aware about these basic Roman numerals. So here let's talk about 259. 259 is 200 plus 50 plus 9. 200 can be written as 2 times C, 50 is L and 9 is IX. Let's take another example. 123. 123 can be written as 100 plus 20 plus 3. 100 is C, 20 is 2 times X and 3 is 3 times I. Now, let us look towards another example, 600. Now, we already know the rule that when a smaller number or smaller symbol is written to the right of bigger symbol, the numbers are added. So, over here, 600 is 500 plus 100. That means DC will give us 600. Now, 2017, if I want to write, I will write 2000 plus 10 plus 7. And 2000 is 1000, mm, 10 is x, and 7 is vii. Now solve the exercise given on page number 22 in your books, in your fair copy.